Hello everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Evolution Worlds. I got some things going on in my life right now. It's a bit complicated. you know what I'm saying? I got a cold, that's why. I got a cold. I'm a bit ill. Fall a bit ill, I guess. We're 4 levels away from being on par with the Ultai Cannon. And what say we are going to kick the Ultai, destroy the Ultai Cannon, kick its ass, and kick Yurka's ass for psychologically fucking with Linear. You know what I'm saying? You know, blah blah blah, whatever happened to script. No, we're gonna set this. You never put two sets of two together, guys. It'll automatically go a set of three and you will lose one. So I do not recommend that at all. Always combine them both like that. And then you combine one with a single. There you go. Look at that. We're gonna combine and combine and combine and combine. Let the powers combine. Oh, fire, wind, water, hot, go planet. By all powers combined, I am Captain Planet. Captain Planet, he's a hero. Gonna take pollution down to zero. Oh la la la, li la la, li la la, ga la la. Captain Planet, he's a hero. Gonna take pollution down to zero. In the heaven, put the saga. I get hot, death to America. You'll pay for this, Captain Planet. We're the Planeteers, and you can be one too. Because hating America is what we do. Looting and polluting is not the way, but if we shoot Americans, if that's the way. Some shit like that. I don't know. Maybe I got them confused with someone else. Anyway. Nalid plus gold gets a Nalid plus gold 2. The sequel to Nalid plus gold 1. Let's try Ixafol. No, we can't do that. Ixafol. How do you pronounce that? Ixafol? Yeah, it's an Ixafol. Ictafols. And we're gonna have escaping sense, and we're gonna have all these feeling shit. We're gonna have so many healing items. We're gonna have any healing items, gonna be hilarious. All these stupid ass healing items. Not that they're stupid ass, but they're really cool. I'm not saying stupid ass as they try to get something, but you know, they're stupid ass. They're good kind of stupid ass. I don't know what I'm talking about. Stupid Black Creek. I don't know. I'm gonna be speaking a lot of gibberish in this part. I don't know why. I am sick, and when I'm sick, I am unpredictable when I'm sick. It's kind of a bittersweet feeling. You're sick, but I got into school, and so I just got out because I was, like, sick. But I think I'm glad I went anyway because it shows how dedicated I am to learning. But it's like I kind of have to stay home so I can recover. But the fact, I think it's like a half-part absence, but I go all that way just to show that I'm sick, you know what I'm saying? And there's all that stuff, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Also, I got packing to do because I got the apartment thing. I'm really hoping that I can get this shit done, and that I can actually clean this place up. I mean, we are trying to clean it up, fellas. You know what I'm saying? And then we clean it up, and we put everything in the boxes. Box! We put everything in the boxes, and then we do all this shit. We box everything. We box all that big shit. But I'm gonna wait for that to get my counselor in there. You know what I'm saying? And numbers, stuff like that, and more numbers. I like numbers. You like numbers? I like numbers. Numbers. Let's add and shit. Yay! Ah. We save the sledgehammers for the spiders. Remember that now. We kill them with hammers. Or we can get a newspaper side frame. I don't know. It's an instant kill. Personally, I am not that afraid of spiders. I do have a few cobweb spiders in my apartment. But especially during this time of year, cobweb spiders are like the best friend you can have, since there are so damn many flying insects around. And I don't want to like eat lunch or dinner or breakfast, all these damn flying insects. So it's like, if there do happen to be any obnoxious little flying insects, the spiders will take care of them. Like, it's like, they not only do they get to eat, but you get to eat too. Because you can actually eat in an environment that doesn't involve those fucking flying insects, you know what I'm saying? And that, Unlike other creatures, spiders don't give a shit with you. And that's what I love about spiders. That's just, I've grown to understand them. I mean, I hear tarantulas are very loyal, but I wouldn't want to own one because they're also fragile. They're like, dare I say, eggs with legs. So, yeah. It is a very hard world for tarantulas to live in. You know what I'm saying? And those money spiders. I'm afraid of killing money spiders. I don't know how a money spider is. They're like those small things. The thing is, when they get on you, it's like, you know, I got it. They're not like ladybugs. They just fly off. So it's like a weird situation. Don't kill a money spider. But what do you do with the money spider? If you kill a money spider, it's not going to be hurt your money. It's a bad luck for killing a money spider. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying, my audience? I don't know. Too superstitious. Ah! Swack them. Boom. But I don't like these spiders, though. Not only are they not authentic, but they're annoying as hell. They take a lot of damage. They're huge dicks. They're giant dildos. And I don't like them. Yeah! 3 more levels, and we get to be on par with the ulti cannon. We're gonna kill that thing. We're gonna destroy that motherfucker. That's what we're gonna do. We're gonna pop a cap in his ass and all, and YOLO, and all that mainstream shit. You know what I'm saying, nigga, motherfucker? You know, mainstream shit. Mainstream. Boom. Yeah, whack. Got him. And jump in the air and do the hammer thing. Mainstream. You know, watching TV kind of hurts my head a bit. Not because it's brain damaging. It's not television itself, it's what's on television. It's all about yellowing and all this cringeworthy shit. And people who don't know what they're talking about because they're retards. I will only get my cable back, though, on the occasion of watching The Simpsons Family Guy crossover. Sure, it has gotten some criticism and stuff for having a lot of meta jokes. And the fact that Family Guy, they do criticize Family Guy for being a rip-off The Simpsons. Personally, I did find it decent. It could have been worse, I guess, but ironically, the animation, the characters do seem to blend in pretty well, I guess. But, yeah, but it does look okay. That's what I got to say on this. Yeah. Let's see how it is. And that's how we get unlimited eat stoles and Alan Royales. Look at that. Look at all those eat stoles. Though it's a savior. Cures everything but those who have fallen. Look at that. We need some somno plus as well. You know, somnos. Those somnos that wake the fuck up, people. Wake the fuck up! You know what I'm saying? That shit. I gotta save. Save my game. Save my game. Rescue my game from not being saved. I'll save you, game, from not being saved. Let's do this. When I was a kid, I don't know what the fuck saving a game was. I didn't know what the fuck saving was. So I was always saving saving Ash's file over my brother's Pokemon Red. Back then, he was the only person who owned a Pokemon. We got Pokemon Red, and I really wanted to get Pokemon Blue. And for my birthday, I did get Pokemon Blue. So we were rivals, and then Steve gets Pokemon Blue as well. And so Steve and I have a level 100 Blastoise for the ultimate climax of one of our duels in Pokemon Red. And no, Blue, you know what I'm saying? 100 level 100 Blastoises. Both of us have level 100 Blastoise, and I came out on top. It was so awesome. You know what I'm saying? I forgot how. I think we were both using water attacks, but I think it was because Steve used all rare candy. So it's karma. Steve is my oldest brother, by the way. But anyway, he was trying to, you know, kind of, you know, get his level up by, artificial levels that he used for his rare candy with our cheat codes and stuff. His cheat codes. And that is why I came out here, because my levels were official. I went through the work. I didn't use the cheats, and I don't think I knew how. for all that matters when I actually put that effort and attention into my Blastoise more than Steve did. And that is why my Blastoise came on top over his Blastoise. And why his Blastoise died in battle. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying, audience? You love your Pokemon. Adore your Pokemon. Appreciate your Pokemon. Hug your Pokemon every day. And your level 100 Pokemon will be killed in a same level mirror match. You know what I'm saying, boys? And girls, and cats, and dogs, and animals watching at home, kids, and people, you know what I'm saying? Oh, yeah, it's like you gotta do that. You gotta do that. I'm gonna use my talent. Let's see, we're 10 minutes in, we have less than 5 minutes to go for this Let's Play, so I keep killing shit. But then I might make one more Let's Play episode before I start watching a Saga Adventure Deluxe Long Play. I'm not going to do a Saga Adventure Deluxe Long Play. Someone else has done a Saga Adventure Deluxe Long Play. And what I'm insisting on is that I will watch and put that long play on my Wii U while I clean up. And if I don't get everything boxed, at least I could show my parents that I am cleanlier now. You know what I'm saying? It kind of felt so, I'm glad that I managed to box my NES. But I am kind of sad that I had to disassemble that beautiful arcade machine. You know what I'm saying, guys? I built an arcade machine. I may have made a video of it. And I connected a Wii to it temporarily so I could show up running Retro City Rampage. But that got a few dislikes and like one like, but that was it. Just a few dislikes. It was weird. Like, why do you dislike that? So I just love the damn thing. Was there something else going on it? Usually I play Super Mario Brothers on the arcade machine. To make it look like a PlayChoice 10 / versus Super Mario Brothers, you know what I'm saying? You know, like that. I have two NES advantages now compared to my one NES advantage because the first one looked lonely, so I went to Swap Shop and bought a second one. You know what I'm saying? It looks so much more lively, less depressing, you know what I'm saying? It looked less like, yeah, you're lonely, don't have any friends, so play me, you know what I'm saying? But now it's like, hey, you have friends? You got another partner? Why don't you play me, buddy? And you can have the time of your life. Mine's the screaming little shits in the arcade, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? It's like the arcade, but mine is the screaming little shits. It's just like that. And you know, it's like, you know, you get to hear all the tracks, you already feel like you're at the arcade. You feel the excitement. You feel the unpredictability. You feel like you can... It's an amazing feeling. You just get it all back. You know what I'm saying? That simple feeling of going to an arcade and being wowed by shit. By the way, it was born in 1991. Let's see here. My favorite arcade game as a kid? Carnival. Yes, everyone's bitching and moaning about how 5-year-olds these days are playing Call of Duty, but this shit's been happening since ancient times. As a 5-year-old, I loved playing Carnival. It was the bomb. It was the shit. It was the shit bomb. But a good kind of shit bomb. You know what I'm saying? Eventually, at 15 years old, I finally beat Carnival for the first time. It was awesome. I just shot the shit out of Token Taker. Eventually, he flew around the propellers. And there was like some kid watching. I didn't see the kid, but my mom mentioned it to me. As I was doing that climactic final battle, Token Shaker, and he was summoning all the skeletons at me, and Umlaut was like dead, and I was like, I final battle, Token Taker, once and for all. And then I finally dealt the final blow to him, and he went flying into one of the blimp propellers, blood shipping everywhere, with a blimp crash. Oh, the humanity, huh? I made a Hindenburg joke. That's real original, huh? But anyway, so that dies, and there's this random woman there. And she's like trying to recuperate. And then we go to the gravestone of friggin' Umlaut or something. And what does my character do? Stupidly, he puts the coin back the fuck in. It's just like an abusive relationship. It sucks. But after getting hit, you hate it. And you had a bad experience. But you just want more! I don't know where that came from. We have less than a minute left. So we're gonna kill this thing. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna use my super beam. Fire! Boom! Fire my link! Never mind. I was gonna make a really, really old meme, but I'm not gonna do that. Oh shit, final weapon. It's shooting balls of shit. It's shitting out of its back. Oh god, it's shitting out of its back. It's meteors. It's the meteors that killed the dinosaurs. Holy shit. I'm gonna use my hammer. I'm gonna use, bottom hammer. Charge up! Boom! Kill him! It will end this episode! He's dead, and this episode is over! Ta-ta! I will see you in part 78! Bye-bye!